Hi, I'm Steve from BoatTest.com, and in this video, we're going to conduct a features inspection of a new yacht from Riviera, the 78 Motor Yacht. This is a yacht that breaks all the molds at Riviera and puts the builder on a solid foundation for the motor yacht industry. And what a yacht it is. Let's get right to it.
We can board the 78 from side decks to both port and starboard, or we can come in on the swim platform, and there are entry gates to both sides of this couch going all the way across the transom. There's a drop-down screen to give us a little privacy. It's also air-conditioned. We can also enclose this whole area, but boy, I sure do like it in this nice open feel. 16 feet by 13 feet with a 7-foot-1-inch high overhead, open and airy. Table over to the starboard side, collapsible. Beverage holders in the center. It's on two fixed pedestals. L-shaped seating, so we can easily sit six here quite comfortably. And look at this over on the port hand side. This is a very interesting little wet bar area, sort of, let's call it an outdoor galley. Aside from the fact that we've got all this counter space, Corian counter, right at the top, there's a sink, right in the center, two electric grills, and then more counter space, and then below the electric grill, refrigeration with glass doors. First we've seen of that, and I really like it. To both sides of the refrigerator, there's trash, and then an ice maker. Forward and up a bit, we've got a storage compartment, and that's repeated over on this side, but here we have an optional TV. Now, because we've got such a wide seating area, this of course pulls out and adjusts to any position we want. Now, even before we get inside this beautiful yacht, the Riviera fit and finish is already coming through. Upholstered to the overhead, Corian counters, sunbrella fabric on the seats, beautifully finished walnut table with a gloss factor of 91.9. 80 is usually the average. Look at the sofa at the back here. Walnut armrest with beverage holders. Now, as far as swim platforms go, I've seen some cool ones, but this one really impresses me for several reasons. First of all, it's hydraulically actuated, so it can drop down underwater, make a private beach, or launch a tender. Bringing it up into this elevated position, now it's out of the way of the prop wash of the boat, that rooster tail that comes up behind it, and it stays dry and it doesn't cause any drag. Moreover, so, is in this elevated position, we've got three steps up, so now it's like a little terrace, an elevated terrace, if you will. Put some deck chairs up here, have a great time watching the kids swimming off the stern. More importantly, however, once we're at the dock, simply remove one of the staple rails and it makes a little passerelle. The garage opens up to give you plenty of access to storage, including dedicated storage for rods and reels and the tender chocks. Notice that there's stairs going down to help you access the interior, and inside the hatch, there are grab handles and control for the shower, plus downlights and a spotlight for the platform. Now we move to the interior of this beautiful yacht through an electrically actuated glass door. This will stay open for just a few seconds and then it'll start closing automatically. But of course, there's also a safety, so if somebody gets in the way of it, breaks the beam, it will open up again, so no harm, no foul. Let's take a look. Beautiful job Riviera did on this. It's such a wide, open and airy layout. Salon is forward, the galley is back, 6-foot-7-inch high overhead, windows all around, so much to talk about, but let's get started right on this aft galley, which is located over to the starboard side. The U-shaped galley has Caesarstone counters, and I noticed that they come down the side for a waterfall effect. Usually you see wood going down the side. It looks much more aesthetically pleasing to me. Plenty of storage all around the bottom and of course up at the top. There's dishwasher, two ovens, inductive cooktop, exhaust fan up above. Always like seeing that. Now we've got a trash receptacle, double basin sink, and look at this. The faucet is actually a hydro tap that will deliver cold water, hot water, and sparkling water. We've got a refrigerator, two freezer drawers, and then over to the opposite side, there are two more refrigerated drawers with storage up on top. We can have that optioned out for another refrigerator. There's an electrically actuated drop-down window at the aft bulkhead. There's also a manually operated shade. With this in the down position, not only does it increase the ventilation going through the main salon, but it also allows you to utilize the galley as a pass-through for serving into the cockpit area. Now, as I come around towards the salon, it occurs to me that it might be a little difficult to deal with the trash that's going into this little container here, but Riviera thought of that by making it pull out from the side. Clever solution. There's storage alongside, storage over here, including drop-down storage, and then the salon. Remarkably comfortable L-shaped seating over to the starboard side. Straight sofa, three across over to the port hand side. There's storage under this sofa.
When it comes time to enjoy a relaxing dinner, a table comes out from the sofa and converts the salon into a dining area.
Having the sofa here gives us comfortable opposing seating, and I also like that there's a very large ottoman right here. And my goodness, are these cushions comfortable. Additionally, as we look forward and up, there's a drop-down 55-inch TV. Now forward into port, there's a wet bar. This one includes glass storage, refrigeration, wine refrigerator, glass storage, and bottle storage. Plenty of open counter space, more Caesar stone, of course, and a removable panel over the single basin stainless steel sink. To the starboard side, simply press the button, unlock the door, and then we have easy access to the side deck. As we make our way to the bow, the forward lounge is accessed from a walkway to the starboard side, and what a comfortable area this is, almost wrapping completely around the whole bow area with comfortable cushions, some umbrella fabric, and we've also got seats that can ratchet up into the reclining position to both port and starboard. Now notice we've still got an open space here, so we can actually load a tender in the center of these that can be launched with this crane right alongside. The high gloss walnut table is on two fixed pedestals. It's collapsible with beverage holders in the center, and notice the rail going around the inside of it. There are fittings in each of the four corners to erect stanchions to put up a sunshade. Now there's another entertainment venue and gathering area up on the flying bridge. Let's take a look at that. Now this flybridge deck starts with a couch over on the starboard side, and I like that these are actual cushions. It's not a built-in couch with fixed cushions. Much more comfortable this way. Ottoman in the center, TV directly across. We've got a little bar area here with refrigeration, a sink, trash receptacle, and an inductive charger. I really like the enclosed flybridge because we can control the climate much better, but if we really wanted to have the open feel, the aft door opens extremely wide, plus we've got these two large windows right here that can be opened completely. And then we've got an opening sunroof. So now we've got fresh air coming right through, sunlight above bringing even more fresh air through that open window, and then the wide open door. Now the electrically actuated door opens to a full width of 6 feet, and of course we can lock it in the open position. Wet bar over to the port hand side. Corian counter. There's a sink underneath, refrigeration, trash, and then an ice maker. Just behind, there are two freestanding chairs, and notice that they can get locked down into position, so we can also enjoy this spot in a seaway. Deck chairs just behind that, out in the open, and over on the starboard side, U-shaped seating wrapping around a pedestal table. And because the table's on a high-low pedestal, we can make it into a daybed. And of course, it is expandable. Now, overhead, we've got the extended shade, and that's an option on most of the boats on Riviera, but on this boat, it is a standard feature. Just ahead, nice conveniently located grab rail, and then a dayhead.
Notice that the companionway has hatches to provide privacy to the bridge. This is convenient whether someone is staying in the bridge or for night vision if you're running the boat and have people down in the salon. And just look at the finish work.
Now let's take a look at the accommodations, but before we go down below, look at the nice work they did on the rails. Leather wrapped, I love the glass on both sides. And then as we go down the stairs, it's a comfortable 9-inch riser to each of the steps. So it feels more home-like than yacht-like on this boat. And now once I get to the bottom of the stairs, it becomes even more apparent that this glass is providing such a benefit of giving us natural light along with the forward windows, making this atrium an open and airy, comfortable atmosphere. Let's start our features inspection down this area with the master stateroom located just aft. Well, a lot to like in this master stateroom. First off, it's full beam. Windows to both sides with integrated port lights, and these are alarmed to the helm. I like seeing that. There's high gloss teak going all the way around, especially decorative headboard work right over there. Vanity desk with mirror and sorter underneath. Storage to both sides, comfortable chair. Bed, 88 inches by 76 inches. Now the bed is electrically actuated to lift at both the head and the foot individually to both sides, and each side gets a remote control. I also like that there are reading lights that activate from white to red on both sides. Now, anywhere we see a surface with the Riviera logo on it, that's an inductive phone charger. Now, over to the port hand side, there's a three across sofa, storage underneath the sofa, there's storage in both nightstands, there's storage forward of the sofa, and there is storage in drawers to both sides underneath the berth. Additionally, there's storage above the windows. I like to see how Riviera always utilizes that space. Other manufacturers just seem to let it go. Lastly, flat screen TV, 43 inches to the forward bulkhead. Now, forward and to port is the master head. It's accessed by a pocket door, which saves so much space rather than having it swing in or out. There are two vessel sinks on top of the silestone counter. There's a separate water closet, and then a walk-in shower is just outboard with a frosted hull side window and an opening port light that adds to the ventilation provided by the exhaust fan. Now, back at the entrance, notice that when the door is opened, it slides into a small pocket, so it's flush with the bulkhead, and then just behind the door, there's a full-length mirror. Opposite, walk-in closet with a hull side window. Now, coming back up into this well-lit atrium, I'm just now noticing that even at night, when we're not getting natural light through these forward windows, that we also have downlights at the forward end of the hardtop that are keeping this area lit. So, clever design feature on Riviera's part there. Now, moving into this hallway, 24 inches wide with a 6'5" overhead, and notice that the ceiling is a drop down, so that allows Riviera to light up the perimeter of it, giving it a nice look. Master was one of four staterooms on board. Second one we'll look at is right over here to starboard. And this is a guest stateroom. This has over under berths at right angles to one another. There's storage above the hull side window that also includes an opening port light and a manually operated shade. Under the upper berth, there's storage. There's also storage at the nightstand. Continuing forward just to the port hand side, this one has twin berths. They're in fixed positions. There's storage under the berths. The headboard is all mirrored, so we are getting even more light coming in from the hull side window, also with an opening port light, and again, there's storage above the hull side window. This one also has private access to the shared head that has another door leading back into the hallway, and this brings us to the VIP, which is fully forward. It has an island berth, 76 inches by 63 inches. Overhead clearance 6'5", which allows us 3'6" above the berth. There's access to both sides, storage above the hull side windows, hanging locker to both port and starboard, and there's additional storage underneath in the form of four drawers. We can also lift the berth to get even more storage. Just at the aft bulkhead, a 32-inch flat screen TV, and this one also has a private ensuite with a separate walk-in shower, hull side window, integrated port light, mirrored cabinet above the sink that is recessed into the silestone, and there's more storage underneath the sink.
Riviera's entry into the highly competitive motor yacht market is a clear indication that the builder is not here as a casual player, but a serious opponent. Personally, there was just so much to like about this yacht that it was impossible to just narrow this video down to the highlights. Even more impressive is her handling, but that's another video. Be sure to look for it. For now, this is my full features inspection of the all-new 78 Motor Yacht from Riviera Yachts. For BoatTest.com, I'm Captain Steve. We'll see you on the water.